Hey everyone, and welcome back to another video. Today's video is going to be comparing niche research tools. I have a lot of experience in this area, so hopefully this video can save you a lot of time and effort trying these out. With that being said, the two big ones that I'm going to compare in this video for you are the two best options that I think you have out there, which are Merch Informer and KWFinder.com. First things first, to all of you guys who are returning to these videos, thank you so much for all the support you've been showing me. I really do appreciate it. I know I say it in every video, but thank you so much. To those of you who may be new to the channel, welcome to the channel. My name is Greg. I like to talk about online entrepreneurship, especially sharing the helpful resources that I wish I had along my journey. So if you're interested in making money online, feel free to look around the channel because you'll find a lot of videos here completely for free that you typically have to pay for in a course. Now, with that being said, today's video is not going to be a long one, but I think it will save you a lot of time from trying out different niche research tools. So the first question you may be having if you are newer to print on demand are, why do you need a niche research tool? And the answer here is a little bit lengthy, but I'll condense it down to just the information you need. The reason that you need a niche research tool is because in the beginning of print on demand, it can be a slow start. The real determining factor of how many sales you're going to get and how quickly you're going to get those sales are which niches you're creating your designs in. Now, you can sell your t-shirt designs on all different print on demand websites. The top three that I recommend are Teespring, Redbubble, and Merch by Amazon. However, the niches that you're uploading into have a big factor on how successful you're going to be. One of the hardest parts of starting print on demand is waiting until you get your first sales. It can be very discouraging when you're just starting out because you don't have a big library or portfolio of designs out there, so you're not getting a lot of traffic to see your designs and you're not getting any sales very quickly. On average, when you're just starting out with print on demand, I have seen from myself and all of the other viewers that I've been talking to in the comments, it can be anywhere from a few days to a few months until you see those first few sales coming in. From my experience, I can definitely say that choosing the right niche or niches to start with in the beginning will determine how quick those first sales come in. To put this in perspective, if you're just starting out in print on demand and you're uploading designs and topics like cats or dogs or coffee, those are some of the biggest topics out there and so many people have designs in them. So if you're just coming in with a few of your designs, it is going to be very hard for your designs to be found by people who are searching through thousands of other designs. However, if you use a niche research tool and you find out that there are more specific niches than cats, dogs, or coffee, then you will have a much better chance of getting your designs found and getting them found quickly. Think along the lines of not just a dog owner as your topic, but a type of dog owner who also likes coffee. So now we bring your niche down from dog to golden retriever owner who likes coffee. It's much more specific and it's much more relevant, and there's going to be far less people competing in that niche. So when you are new to that niche, your designs will essentially go right up to the top because you're not competing with a lot of people. So this is exactly where the niche research tool comes in, because you can find out which one of these specific niches has the least competitors in it and where your best chance of getting sales are. So now hopefully we're on the same page of where you're going to use your niche research tool and why it's so important in the beginning. Now let's talk about the different tools out there. Now, in the last 5+ years that I've been in print on demand, I have used a lot of niche research tools. Some are better than others, and some are different on a fundamental level, and that's what I'm going to explain in this video. From all of the different niche research tools I've used in the past, I kind of boiled it down to just two. One of them is called Merch Informer, and the other one is called KWFinder.com. Now, first off, one of the main reasons that I like both of these is because they both have free trials. So if you are new to this and you don't want to spend any money, you just want to try them out, you can actually use both of these and see the results without paying for anything. Now, beyond the free trial, it brings us into the first comparison factor, and that is price between the two of these. Merch Informer has a 3-day free trial, and then it's about $10 per month. Moving on to the other side with KW Finder, it has a 10-day free trial, and then it's about $30 per month. Now, although KW Finder has a longer free trial of 10 days, their price per month afterwards is pretty steep. It's $30 per month and they do not have any discounts. Moving back over to the other side of Merch Informer, although they only have a 3-day free trial, once you do sign up, it's only $10 per month and they have a 20% off discount, which is linked down in the description. So it's about $8 per month. Once you're past the free trials, I would definitely be recommending you to Merch Informer for only $8 per month. You get their niche research tool among other things that they offer in their tool. KW Finder for 30 $30 per month, I think is just too much money. I can definitely stand behind their 10-day free trial, but after that, I do not recommend paying $30 per month to use their tool. So now that we've talked about price between the two, now I want to move on to the core functionality and how they are different, which a lot of people do not actually realize. When you're doing niche research, especially for print on demand, you first need to take a step back and figure out what data is being pulled and compared in that tool. Now with that in mind, when we look at Merch Informer, Merch Informer actually uses data from Merch by Amazon. Merch by Amazon is one of the largest print-on-demand websites. The reason that I really like this is because you're talking about niches specifically in print-on-demand. You're not talking about niches for general Google searches. Now, since Merch by Amazon is one of the largest print-on-demand platforms, what I personally do is I take that information on that specific niche and I just assume that it is the same for Teespring and Redbubble as well. I have personally been doing this for a while and I can see that the information is pretty spot on for all three platforms. Now, when we come over to the other side of KW Finder, yes, it is going to give you good information on niches. However, we have to look at what data is being compared. The data that is being used for KW Finder is general search data. It's going to give us good information on what niches are competitive and which ones are not competitive where we want to go. However, we need to read between the lines and make sure that that information also applies to print on demand. Since it's using general search data and not specifically print on demand search data, it means that we could have a lot of extra data in there that could be throwing off our results. So with that being said, when you're comparing the two of these on a core functionality level, Merch Informer is going to give you specifically print on demand niche research. This is really what we're here for. KW Finder is going to give you general information on what people are searching. So it's very important to understand the difference between the two. Now moving on to the last of three categories that you really should know when comparing Merch Informer to KW Finder, and that is ease of use. If you have seen any of the other videos on this channel, I'm always talking about efficiency in print on demand. The way that you really succeed in print on demand is staying efficient. You don't want to be spending hours on certain tasks that could take you only minutes if you were using a different tool. With that being said, both Merch Informer and KW Finder are very easy to use. They use two different systems, but they're both very efficient. Starting with Merch Informer, you type in your niche. If it's a single word, you just type it in. If it's a phrase or a multiple word search, you just put quotes around it, but then it's going to give you a letter grade, A through F. This is just like in school. If you get an A, that means it is a very good niche, and that is definitely one you should write on your list of niches. If you get an F, it means that it is way too saturated, too competitive. I would not recommend it. But the reason that I like Merch Informer is you quickly type in your niche and you can see your letter grade and know right away, is it an A, is it somewhere in the middle, or is it an F? Moving over to KW Finder, they use a color system with a number system. So essentially it's going to go from green to red. If it is bright green, then that means it is good, essentially an A. If you get a red, that means that it is not good and it is essentially an F. Also, they put a number score with it from 0 to 100. So basically, if you're using KW Finder, just look at the colors and you'll be able to check that niche and you'll be able to see, is it green or is it red? So both of these are very easy to use and you can efficiently find information on niches. At the end of the day, I can definitely recommend both of these on free trial. You should try them both out and you'll get a feel for either of them. Using KW Finder, you're going to get a general overview of niches on the internet. Using Merch Informer, you're going to get information specifically about niches on print on demand. Additionally, after the free trial, Merch Informer is only $8 per month compared to $30, so I can definitely recommend that. Now, the last thing I'd like to put in this video, which I think will be helpful for you, are a couple reputable free options that I found over the years. The two that I can definitely recommend for you are Google's Keyword Planner. It's completely free forever. It may be a little bit difficult to set up your account. In order to get the detailed results, you need to have a Google Ads account, but once that's set up, you can get pretty detailed results. Now, Google Keyword Planner is like KW Finder, where it's going to be using general search data, not specifically print-on-demand data, so keep that in mind as well. And then the other one I can suggest to you is called Uber Suggest. Again, it's going to be just like Google Keyword Planner and KW Finder, where it's using general search data, not specifically print-on-demand data, but those are two free options that you can try and they are free forever. So with all of that being said, I know this was not a long video and it had a lot of information very quickly in it, but I hope it has been helpful in saving you some time of actually comparing these yourself. With that said, if you enjoyed this video, feel free to give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. And as always, if you have any questions about these that were compared in this video or any others, just let me know down in the comments and I can help you out. All right, guys, that's it for this one. I'll keep an eye on the comments to get you some answers back and I'll see you all in the next video.